Hi, this is John Bennetts here from Total Rockstar Blueprint, and in this short GarageBand tutorial, I'll be showing you how to set up instrument and audio tracks and recording using, of course, GarageBand. In the Arrange page at the top, you'll see the timeline, which illustrates the bar lines we'll be working with. On the left-hand side is the area where all the instrument and audio headers will sit as we create them. At the bottom of the page, we have our transport controls with the record, playback, fast forward, rewind, and loop buttons. To set up an instrument track, we go down to the left-hand bottom corner of the page and click on the button with the plus sign, which gives us three options to choose from. The first is the software instrument for the GarageBand onboard instrument selections. The second is real instrument, which is for microphone input, keyboards, or guitars, and the third choice is for the electric guitar, which you can choose if you want to use the onboard guitar amplifiers and effects. We're going to choose software instrument, click create, and this will add the default grand piano instrument onto the arrange page. I'm going to change that now to a drum sound, so I'll click on drum kits, and I'm going to choose the hip hop kit. Before I begin my recording, I need to set up a metronome and counting click, and this is done in the control drop-down menu. Click metronome and count in to activate them. Then at the bottom of the page, I'll set up my tempo. It defaults to 120 beats per minute, so I'm going to change that to a more hip-hop tempo of 92 beats per minute. So next I click the record button, or I can just click the shortcut, which is letter R, to activate the record mode and start recording our track. Okay, I've now got a rough drum track, so let's clean that up. Double left click on the recorded region to open up the piano roll and score windows. In the piano roll window, highlight all the MIDI notes, and then we can choose how much we want to quantize our track using the Align 2 function. I'm going to choose 1/16th note heavy swing to lock in our grooves. Now we're going to loop our part. So put your cursor over the top right-hand corner of the region till you see the circle with an arrow. Then left-click, hold and drag the region to as long as you want the section to play for. I will just play this from bar 4, and you can see the loop repeats at bar 5. Okay, so I have my first instrument track, tempo, and created the loop. So now I'm going to create an audio or real instrument track. When creating an audio instrument, we need to make sure we set the input source. Just click the input source button, and generally it recognizes the input, and in this case, it's found my Rode Podcaster microphone. To test my input level, I mute the drum track and hit record and adjust the volume level. I want a nice strong signal, but not too loud that it distorts. This here is the audio waveform. Once I've got this set up, I turn off the metronome so it doesn't bleed through onto my audio recording. Normally, when you're recording an audio track, you'd use headphones to stop any spill going through into the microphone. I'm just going to record a bit of guitar along with my drum track. And that's it. Just keep repeating this process till you put down all your music and your vocals. And have fun.
I hope you enjoyed today's GarageBand tutorial. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button so you get all the latest updates as they become available. And I'll see you on the next video.